Hi everyone, today I'm going to share with you my houseplant collection. So I started buying houseplants in the summer of 2019. I was going through a really difficult time in my life and I just wanted to have something that I could take care of or be responsible for because I had hoped that it might help me get out of bed in the morning. And well, it worked because as of today, I currently have 12 live plants in the house and I think the collection's just gonna keep growing because it has been so fun getting to know each and every one of these plants and I'm really excited for you to get to know them too. So let's start. That I ever bought was a golden pothos and I named him Sebastian or Sebi for short. If you watch my old Monday Eats videos, you might remember seeing him around my house. I got him from a small plant shop just across my apartment in Brooklyn, New York, and at the time I had no idea how to take care of a plant. I didn't know about watering, I didn't know about sunlight, I didn't know about the soil or what pot to use. I just followed the instructions that they gave me, which was to water once every 2 weeks, and that was exactly what I did. However, I started noticing that the plant was wilting a lot and the leaves were turning yellow, and when I googled it I learned that yellowing leaves meant that it was getting too much sunlight and wilting leaves meant that I wasn't watering it enough. I was really confused at the time because they said once every 2 weeks and that's exactly what I've been doing, but something that I didn't take into account was the humidity of the apartment and the placement of the plant. So I used to have Sebi on the windowsill of my bedroom, which was facing east, meaning that it got full sunlight from sunrise all the way until late noon, and that was just too harsh on his leaves, which caused it to yellow. And also, I had this plant really close to my radiator, so when the heater was on, the air in the bedroom became really dry. The soil had been drying out much faster than it normally did in the summer, and that's why the leaves were wilting, because I was still watering it only once every 2 weeks. So that's how I learned that I should actually be looking at the soil to see if the plant needed to be watered yet or not. Now I just do this thing with all my plants where I dip my finger into the top layer of the soil, maybe around like an inch or something, and if it feels dry all around, then I think it's time to be watered. The second plant I bought was a silver satin pothos. I named her Artemis after the silver variegation on her leaves, and I call her Artie for short. I bought this from a shop near Chinatown called The Sill, and when I got it, it was much smaller than it is now. So far, it's vined out a lot, as you can see, and also it's growing all these taller leaves, which are gonna fall down and become even more vines. This plant really thrives in low light, and direct sunlight can cause it to lose the variegation on its leaves. As you can see, some of these leaves have been exposed to too much sunlight and it's already starting to yellow and burn off, which is why I moved this plant to the bookshelf so that it could have a little bit of shade and a little bit of indirect sunlight. This is one of the plants that I've had with me in New York and I've also brought over here since quarantine started, so I feel very emotionally connected to it. This pretty succulent over here is called a lipstick echeveria. It has flower-like leaves and also red details on the tips. I bought this one from a Trader Joe's around the same time that I got Artie, and at first it had these really pretty red tips on the edges, but it's starting to lose it now, which I still don't know why. This one likes full direct sunlight, so I keep it by the windowsill at all times. Because of the red tips that it used to have, I named this one Rosie, and also because it has little thorns, and roses have thorns. This one likes to be watered around once every week, but sometimes I also check the soil to see if it's dried yet, because plastic planters can contain moisture better than terracottas. This one is a variegated Peperomia obtusifolia, sometimes called the baby rubber plant. I personally nicknamed this one Mia so that I could have a Sebastian and Mia, like the main characters from La La Land. I also bought this one from The Sill and I really like how the leaves are thick and rubber-like, hence the name baby rubber plant. Mia was kind of dormant in the winter, but now that spring has arrived, she's been sprouting a lot of baby little leaves, and since I started feeding her fertilizer, she's been doing really, really well. I placed her on a wooden crate that's slightly lower than the windowsill so that she could receive both direct and indirect sunlight. This is another plant that I brought from back home in New York, so I'm really attached to it as well. This one is a pink angel plant or a growing nerve plant, which I nicknamed Pinky. I bought this one from Lowe's for around $4, I think, so it wasn't expensive at all. I didn't plan on repotting this one at first, but I started to notice little roots coming up from the nursery pot, so I changed into this one. And within 3 days, the plant wilted so aggressively, like all the leaves were drooping down the sides, and it just looked like it was ready to die. It scared me so much, but that's how I learned that terracotta pots absorb a lot of the water from the soil, which means that the soil will dry out more quickly. So if you decide to put a plant in a terracotta pot, you need to water it more often than you normally would. These next three plants are my boyfriend's babies, and they are grown from seeds that we bought from Target. This is a wheatgrass or cat grass that we bought for Mosa to eat because grass helps long-haired cats digest their hairballs. And this one is rosemary and peppermint. Next two plants I ordered from Amazon. The first one is an English ivy, which was actually sent to me by mistake. I ordered a cast iron plant, but they sent me the wrong one. I just kept it because it's so beautiful. The English ivy is a vining plant that grows really, really fast, so this one has been sprouting a lot of new leaves since I got her. From what I've read, this one is really, really difficult to kill. It can survive in all kinds of lighting conditions, both low light, direct or indirect sunlight. However, it will only thrive in bright direct sunlight, which is why I placed it on the bookshelf because I didn't want it to grow too quickly. This one is a philodendron Congo green, which I also got from Amazon. Out of all the plants that I mentioned so far, this is the only one that's toxic to cats, dogs, and people. So even after repotting this, I needed to wash my hands with soap to be careful. This one prefers indirect sunlight to low light, and ever since I moved into our bedroom, it started to sprout this little leaf from the soil, which got me really excited. This philodendron gets root rot really easily, so I recommend that you pot it in a well-draining pot like this terracotta right here. I also have this plastic tray underneath that catches all the water that comes out from the bottom of the pot so I can just dump it out and make sure that none of the roots are sitting in water for too long. This next one is called Million Hearts, and I also bought it from Lowe's. It's so small and cute, and I think these trailing leaves are so beautiful. I water this one around once a week, and I place it on the windowsill where it gets pretty much a lot of bright sunlight. I've only had it for a few weeks, but you can already see new leaves sprouting out from the vines. This one is a variegated calathea called Calathea Beauty Star, and I call her Callie or Taurus sometimes, like the doctor from Grey's Anatomy. I bought it from a shop on Etsy called California Tropicals, which I will link down in the description box. And like other calatheas, this plant enjoys indirect sunlight and humid conditions. So far, she's been quite a diva to me. If I let the soil dry just a little too much, her leaves will turn brown very quickly. So I put these river rocks on top of the soil to help her retain moisture. And this one is non-toxic to cats, so I can keep it at Mosa height. This next one is one of my newest plants. It's called a watermelon peperomia, and I've always wanted this plant, so I was really excited to get it in the mail. I also ordered this one from Etsy, and I nicknamed him Milona, but the name hasn't stuck yet. This one has really pretty red stems and big round leaves that look like watermelons, which is why it's called watermelon peperomia. The leaves are also thick and rubber-like, which is really similar to the peperomia obtusifolia. If you remember from my previous vlog, the leaves were really wilted at first, but after watering, it grew all the way up, and I'm so proud of it. And last but not least, I have these marantas, which come with a story of their own. This is the Maranta lemon lime that I introduced to you in my last vlog. So unfortunately, this one had a really rough start. It got lost in the mail for more than a week, and by the time it got to me, most of the leaves had already started dying. And I also noticed that there was mold all over the surface of the soil. So I immediately repotted it, and this plant also likes a lot of humidity. So I put it in the bathroom and added rocks on top of the soil, hoping to retain some of the moisture. but it just kept wilting and dying. And so I took it out of the soil and I noticed that parts of the root had begun to rot. I don't know if this is due to my overwatering or if it was the mold that I didn't clean out completely from when I first got it. I decided to cut off all the roots around like a centimeter below the node of the plant, hoping that I might be able to propagate it. And I have two of these cuttings in water right now. This one is actually starting to grow roots, which I was really excited about. And this one, we're just gonna have to wait and see. So when this was missing, I messaged the store to ask if they could help me in any way, and I kept them updated even when it arrived. So I showed them the picture of like the soil and the leaves and everything. And I know that it's like a weird time with COVID and everything, it's not their fault. But to apologize for it, they offered to send me a new plant, and that's how I got my huge red Maranta lucanera. So Maranta plants are also nicknamed prayer plants because their leaves move up in the evening and then come down in the morning, kind of like a prayer. And this has quickly become one of my favorites because it's just really nice to notice the movement of the leaves as the day goes by. It makes me feel like there's life in the house, and it's so exciting to see it like this way when I go to sleep and then this way in the morning. So that was my houseplant collection. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and maybe learned a little something from it. I just want to say that I still consider myself a pretty new plant mom, so I'm sure I've made some mistakes. If you have any tips and tricks for how I could take care of my plants better, please, please let me know because I would love to learn. And if you're thinking of getting a houseplant, I really encourage you to do so. They brighten up your living space so much and they're just so calming to look at. And yeah, if you like this video, please leave a comment, like, or subscribe. That would really, really make my day. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you in my next one. Bye!